I'm back, ready to do this. My name is Jason, and I do video game development. I've been doing indie game dev stuff for the last close to 9 years now, working on Kria, which is out on Steam and has been out for a number of years, and I've been kind of figuring out what to do next. Now I'm working on a new game called Autoforge. Right now we're going to be looking at PlayFab, which is a product from Microsoft Azure. This is a sponsored stream by Microsoft Azure, so thank you to them for actually, like, you know, reaching out. What we're going to be doing is exploring what is PlayFab. I have tried to keep myself as, like, pure as possible while still not going in completely blind. Looked at a few little things for PlayFab, but for the most part, we're just going to be exploring it, figuring out what PlayFab is, what you can do with it. Yeah, I think it'll be fun. Do what it's capable of. I think what would make the most sense is to kind of just look at the tutorial to start with and see what are kind of like the features that they have. Here they have a what is PlayFab. And so this is the product. It's, as they say, a complete backend platform for live games with managed game services, real-time analytics, and live ops. Really, what I'm really interested in is being able to bring players together, but not have to necessarily do some huge, you know, MMO. So I think that's what we're really going to be looking out for. I think that having some backend that could kind of just like allow players to connect easily would go such a long ways. And I've even kind of designed out some, you know, possible features that we would use this backend for to be able to really help kind of unite players, make them feel truly connected. So let's go ahead and jump into PlayFab and really start seeing what it is about. So yeah, they actually go over like all the major features here. So this is pretty nice. Here's a big one is they have cross-network identity. That's really nice where you can say, hey, I want to be like, I want to connect through Steam or like PSN. Cross-network identity stuff, you could say, hey, this is my Steam account and my Nintendo Switch friend code, whatever it's called, and be able to use that, but also to be able to jump between on the Switch and on Steam. There's like chat, that's pretty standard, that's cool though, that makes sense. Leaderboards, pretty standard, that's cool though. One thing I'm seeing here that I really like about this provides a lot of functionality. This is really good to have a central place where all of your platforms can connect and players can be able to play together, because it's so critical to have your player base not be split, because if you don't get large enough, then kind of just like immediately fizzle out. I really like that there's this all-in-one solution here that is cross-platform. So beyond that, they have this like engagement and retention thing, and this starts getting more into the storefront sort of stuff, player buckets. So actually this is pretty cool. There's so often in game design, it's really hard to know what's going to be better. With something like this, you can actually get solid data. You know, a really good example might be, let's say that you come up with a tutorial. You're not really sure how you want to present the tutorial to players, and you're interested in like the player retention. My understanding is that you could say, okay, here's this player group and here's this other player group. You know, one player gets tutorial A and this other player group gets tutorial B. And let's see which players like stick around longer. And you can then use that information to decide what is the best tutorial for the game. And I think that's really neat. Typically, I definitely like user-generated content. I'm curious to see what that ends up looking like. Virtual economies, even if you're not doing monetization, can be very interesting. And that's something that I was thinking about is like, would it be possible to make a RPG sandbox game, not an MMO, but you do have some virtual economy? And I think that could be interesting, like having some items in the game that are very rare that players could trade, you know, more or less auction house sort of feature in the game. The one challenge with that is like fraud prevention, and I'm not really sure the best way to do that. Wow, they have so many features. PlayFab is huge. So CloudScript, I took a peek at this. So maybe through this, you could say drops happen through the cloud script. There's so much of this that really neat, thinking of it like as a way to make an MMO without having to have a full-on server. Like just really making it feel like you are connected. Like you can even, with real-time translation, unite your players even between different languages, which is like a huge problem, or a challenge, I should say. Monitor a unified real-time stream. Okay. Real-time analytics. That's pretty cool. Oh no, I think this could be used in a lot of ways. Usually I would think it's kind of for player retention, but I could see it being used for other things. They have a lot of SDKs. I was kind of taking a peek. I'm curious to see kind of what the API looks like. What would it take to integrate it into a game engine? I could quite possibly use any of these. Could probably use either the C++ or the Lua one. Now that we've kind of looked at PlayFab, we have a good understanding now of all of the functionality that they do provide. Let's take a look. How do we kind of get things set up and get things moving? And then we can also play around with PlayFab itself. And then we can kind of go back and forth a little bit on the documentation as well as this other stuff. So yeah, let's actually get started at the top here. So they say that you need to get some title ID. Okay, so we have this game here. Here's a game. I think this is fine. Yeah, we can look at the SDKs in a bit. I'm actually really interested in the CloudScript stuff. So it says CloudScript is JavaScript code that lives on a remote server, and you can execute it either from a rule or directly from a client. I'm curious what that directly from a client is. What I've seen so far is that they kind of assume that you're using Unity, which is a pretty safe assumption, to be fair. We're not, but we can kind of like translate or imagine what it might look like in, you know, C++ or Lua, whatever we would actually use. Wow, so you actually can like define the whole entity on the server. That's interesting. I guess you would have to do that if you wanted to be able to store player data. We can look at this in more detail. I'm just kind of like browsing it. You know, we don't want to dive too deep into a single thing. Like you can see there's a lot of information here. Drop tables. Oh, wow, they have drop tables too. Let's kind of pop, go back up. Get random results table. What's this? Evaluate random. I wonder what that is. Wow, they really have this like all set up. This is kind of crazy. Just like looking at all this stuff. Oh, you could do this and that and that. It's actually pretty cool. A lot of this is just like completely untapped. Kind of jumping around here just a little bit. Like we barely even looked at this. It's really looking like a great way to be able to bring players together and really have like great connectivity. Really excited about it. It looks great. We have not looked at this yet, so I feel like we probably should do that. Okay, so just kind of exploring it. Kria NG, you know, the next game. Kria 2! I wonder what this is actually used for. Like, where is this being displayed? Monetization, paid to download. I mean, you could say this. We're on all of the platforms. Title audit history. I wonder what that is. Oh, I see. That's probably for that logo is this displayed for us. Keep looking. Players, you can see all the players that have logged in. This is impressive that you have all of this information that you could look at on a player. Like, it's kind of crazy. Looks like you can link identities. Earlier we asked that question, can you link multiple like identities? It looks like the answer is yes. PlayStream. We looked at PlayStream earlier, right? So that's just like everything. Like, hey, this player killed a monster. They, you know, opened up a treasure chest. That's so crazy that you could be able to track like what players are doing. It's like almost follow the story or the player's narrative of like, oh yeah, it looks like they went over here and they were fighting the monsters. Oh, it looks like they leveled up. And then they went back to the base and they like crafted these items. And so you could actually get like a nice picture of what players are doing. We'll keep moving on. Hey, look, you can add friends. You can have your own like friend group here. Objects. Okay. Files. This entity may store up to 10 files. Okay, this is for hosting a server. This is where you can have a dedicated server that is running through PlayFab. Okay, let's keep digging through the website here. Okay, so you can do like clans and whatnot. Oh, hey, look, there's a CloudScript, huh? That's pretty crazy that you could just like write this stuff and put it on here. experimentation feature helps you identify the best strategies for your game. It does so by helping you run multiple concurrent experiments and ensures statistical trustworthiness. Okay, so I think what we're going to do is to wrap this up. Having any sort of online presence, PlayFab seems like a pretty good option. Looks awesome. But thank you guys for joining. I really appreciate those that have like stuck around, joined me on this journey of exploring PlayFab. I'm glad I had like a reason to actually look at this. I hope you have a good rest of your day. Take care. Later, guys.